Right, so I'm deep into this documentation of the indigenous self. Namely, I'm starting with my father because he has so many aspects, so many, I call them free-for-alls, that he is just free with being Indian in these respects. Okay. Now, as he's older and older and older in life, he's lost certain things. When we were raised as children, for example, he had a knife collection and the hatchet collection, and he would throw these again and again and again at the wood in the back garden. And I'm like, what a barbarian father that I have. You know, why would he have to do this? You know, all these other ones are in their suits that are going off to work or whatever. And he's out there just again and again. Originally I'm like, well, maybe I'm Hungarian, and it goes back to that knife throwing with the lady in the balloons. But now this is becoming indigenous, native. A comfortability factor with the knives, and I'm talking the little hatchets. He's always had several of those, and lots of knives. Always even has them near his bedside, sleeps with a knife nearby. He is that type of person. So this is like a natural. I'm out the door and I am an Indian, and it could be a reason, you know, that I have to go attack or kill in any given moment. So he comes from this type of tribe, and thusly I do also. So we are an aggressor group that handles weapons. And so it's very exciting, because some of these that I'm reading about, they're like little pansies, and they don't do very much. They're gardeners only, and they don't do very much else. And they're just kind of swayed around by this group of Indian or another group of Indian that sways them, you know. They're like the pests. They just are out there gardening, a lot of gardening. So finding that out. Now we go into Indian song. In his youth, when I was a child, he was very open to singing Indian chants out of the blue. And I'm like, well, that's a weird guy. And at first I'm like, well, maybe it is something he can't help. It's just the only way he knows how to sing. You know, it's just like obnoxious. And now I'm like, no, he really is the Indian who was singing. Okay. So then now I'm like, no. But now I have to return to his dancing aspect. Okay. And of course he plays the drums non-stop his whole entire life. But the dancing aspect, the dancing with the little small steps, you know, tiny steps, that type of dancing, where you're just in one place and you just move just a little bit, almost like a shuffle dance, that type of dancing is how he danced as I'm growing up as a child. I'm like, what a weirdo. You know, he doesn't dance like these other ones, you know, the Norman Rockwell dance, where with the one arm this way and the one arm that way, and there's my mother, and they're the hallmark. No. He's on his own. He's a very much on his own type. So, meaning, oh no, the wife is just out. My mother is just the squaw who cooked and cleaned and could take care of the kids. That's it. And he's just like in charge to sing and dance and throw his knives into the wood at his own whim, and that is his boss. You know, he is the boss of those moments. And me as a family child, there's nothing I can do. There's nothing I can do. I am just the subject of his particular reign, you know, his kingdom, and that's the way it is. So he conducted our childhood, actually, as an Indian chieftain, and I just didn't realize it. I didn't realize it at the time, and I don't even believe he realized it. And now, unfortunately, his later years, he's not cognizant of it. He just knows what he likes still. He knows he likes feathers. He knows he likes the collecting rocks. Oh my gosh. Yeah, there was a woman up the street just this last week, madder than all hell, because he just took a rock right out of her garden and he moved it to go sit down somewhere else in her garden. And she was just madder than hell at him and telling him to get out. And just like, well, yeah. I mean, what do you do? Then when they're old, they're old. They're tired. They just want to sit down. Okay. So now he's made an enemy. But that's the way he's conducted himself his entire life. As where he walks, where he goes, as his space. Unfortunately, as life has become more Europeanized in his mind, I believe he's been, pushed down by the Western society, pushed down and quieted. Just pushed down and quieted, you know. And I'm asking him, you know, from his jilted memory, does he have any memory back to his mother and his father, his grandmother, grandparents, great-grandparents? Does he remember them dancing? Does he remember them singing? Does he remember them throwing knives? Any of these aspects? Does he remember that? He doesn't have any recollection of these moments. Okay, so then I'm like, well, so this is weird. Because I was really hoping, so one of them was just, I do know that one of my grandfathers walked a lot, like he walked just miles and miles and miles every day. So I know that went on. But now I'm like, okay, there are still more hints, there have to be more hints, there have to be more clues. Okay, I have one great-grandfather. Now he was a Thompson. Now Thompson, like the grapes. Now he lived on a reservation. He lived there, and chances are maybe I'm a product of that reservation. A reservation here in the Southwest. Now Mr. Thompson, Philetus Thompson is his name. He had, what was his reason? I think he was a war escapee. He did not want to be in war, the Civil War. I think that was his reason for joining the reservation, joining the tribe, essentially. He joined that tribe. So Philetus Thompson latched on to that reservation and lived there way back then. So he was taken into their group. And we don't even know the name of the tribe. That's how bad the brains are on the fallout since then. We're talking great, great grandfather to me, a great grandfather to my father and his siblings. They don't remember the name of the tribe that Philetus lived on. So it's incredibly frustrating. Okay, now we have. Over there we have the Fountain man, who is the lawyer, the Colonel Fountain. Now, he did a lot of work as a lawyer and attorney for the Mescalero Apache. The Mescalero Apache, apparently, they had a time where the Western, what do they call them, the white man, said you can only have one wife, and the Mescalero Apache at that time wanted two. or multiple, and they didn't want that block. And so he became their lawyer. He was their lawyer, and he ironed it out for them so that they could have multiple wives. So that's what my great-grandfather did. You know, he was the fountain. He was the fountain from France. Now, I don't believe he lived on the reservation, but I know that he did help the Indians with their lawyer-ness. But yeah, so Philetus is a big, big point, a big clue. We're looking at him. I know the Thompson family itself, later, many of them went out to California. Some of them became famous or in the movies or whatever. But they did a lot. They went to California and had a huge ranch there. But here in this southwest area was not anything like that. It was just, the only thing I know is right now is in my father's youth was the Indian dancing that he just does naturally, the shaking of all of these sticks that have the seeds in them. He does all of that. Very unabashed. You understand, when they're unabashed and they don't have like a qualm or a conscious self associated, you know, it's a natural habit, it's a natural organism that is creating that cultural self. He can't help it. That is how he dances, that is how he sings, and that is how he throws knives. So this is how he treats women also. All of these things fall out from this group. I'm very, very convinced of it. So if I can only know the reservation name, I don't know. But yeah, I sometimes hate history because it'll send you on this trail and you're like stuck at the button and I'm like, no, I want another name. I want another name. I want another name. I need help. I need to know who you are, because they keep sending us off to Spain, and now I'm like, yes, we're sent off to Spain again, and another one to send to Spain, you know, the now that we have the Carajabals or something, and there's some kind of a city in Spain. Okay, so great, so we're sent off to a city in Spain, and now we're the Bascos, you know, and those are interesting. So we have a whole bunch of neat little names that are starting to crop up in Spain. And, but yeah, but I really want to know about this Indian heritage here and now. That's very exciting. Very exciting. And no, I don't believe I have any Chinois in the line. I don't believe so. I am liking the results from the ancestry, but in the same tone, I want more information. I don't understand why the site itself isn't giving me the link throughs. You know, I click on the name, why aren't I getting the link throughs, and then add it in right away, all of them, you know, all 100 names or 1,000. Why can't I do that? Why do I have to do it by myself? Each person, it seems, erroneous errors, and it's like it's just like a fantasial place to enter the data. I'm not liking this. I prefer using the family search now and the genie.com. Those are real databases from the GEDCOM, and it's not just made up. I'm believing that there's a prone to being made up there in those ancestry ones. If you link a tree to yours, and it's just like a leaf, a little hint, if you link that hint, it could be the wrong hint. And I have no way of linking, like some of these people have 700 hints or, you know, association. And I can't even get access to them unless I do it one by one. I don't know, maybe I'm dumb and I haven't figured out how to just say, hey, move your tree into my tree. It's not working. I can't seem to do that. It's So it's making it like a tedious process. And so, yeah, I'm not paying $20 again, or ever for it, and I'm just not going to. I appreciate the ancestry lookup of the DNA, but they have to make it more of an easier, you know, hello. You know, somebody's already done the work, it's already been officialized, then bring those names. Bring those names through. Why do I have to do that again? You know. Anyway. So yeah. Ooh, yeah. He's into all that. Yeah.